filming our 6th quarantine session, and today we're going to work on some inspiration and education for the Touch It pattern or game. So we've got some questions through Facebook, which was awesome, and I wanted to show you guys how we built this exercise and how you can make it more interesting for your horse. So of course I wanted to talk about all the zones of the horse, which you find on internet as well. So if you're doing a level 1-2, you stay in front, and if you're doing a level 3-4, you go a little bit more behind. So first of all, I have placed a lot of objects in the arena, and I'm going to show my horse what I've put here and discover it together. So let's make it a game. Because he likes his work now and he gets what he needs to do. So that was the first object. The second object is a little bit bigger. We're going to the pole. No, yes, that's it. So most of the horses that have a hard time putting their feet on something, it's really important to make your steps smaller. So when they're already looking at the object, you say, yay, you're such a good boy, I love you, and you send positive thoughts. And then when you send them a little bit closer and closer, actually with him, it was an accident that he touched it with his foot, because he was searching and searching and stepping a little bit, and then when he touched it with his foot, I was super positive, and then he kind of got it, like, hey, what did I do? Like, I did something good, maybe? And then we tried it again and again, and then at a certain moment he got it. So that was really interesting. Next up, let's go. This is his favorite one, and I think this is a very easy object to work on such a thing, because they can really stand on it. And it's the same principle as with trailers. So everything towards the object is positive and good. Everything that is going away, let them be, but send them back. So it's the release that feeds it. That's very important. So I'm going to send my horse and see what he does. Yeah, good boy. Good boy. Good boy. And for those who have trouble with objects under the horse, it's a very good idea, instead of taking them back for the object, sending them over, because in that way the object is under your horse and they get more confidence with it. Good boy. And then you can start building this as well with bigger and bigger objects. Interesting. or go backwards or way through. Good boy. But as you can see, he's already quite confident. When they move their horse, their feet, the target follows, the tarp follows a little bit, so that could be scary. And what if I wheel? I make wings. Is he still confident with it? Good boy. So I hope you saw how you can build this exercise through the levels and how you can play with it and get creative. So enjoy, and I hope this was interesting for you. Send your videos. I would love to give some comments on them. And thank you for listening. And questions, please ask. We'll be ready for you.